That's it. I have two dogs, and I like to watch videos, listen to music. I like memes, and that's it. What about you, Andrea?
Yes, hello guys. My name is Andrea. I'm 45 years old. I was born in São Bernardo do Campo, but I lived in Guarujá since I was 7. I am married. I don't have kids, but I have a lot of plants. I am a mother plants. What else? My free time, I love listening to music, drink wine, and study English. That's it.
Nice.
Do you like drinking wine, Andrea?
Yes, I love it.
I love
Wine,
drinking wine.
beer, caipirinha. I love
Yes.
drinking.
That's the stuff. I have, I don't know if this is the right way, but I signed an app called Evino with my girlfriend. So
Very
we had
nice.
like two bottles of wine in a month, and I just something that I love too much, you know?
I
That's
will
great.
try to do it. Yeah, thank you.
You pay a month, right? I was seeing something like that. Like they give you, like you pay, but they give you one per month, a specific wine, and you can try it if you like it. I think that's nice. Wine
Yeah,
is good.
we subscribe to drinking wine to receive bottles of wine. That's great, man. Today you can subscribe for anything you want to, you
Yeah,
know.
yes, and there's a good point. They said that wine is good for heart, you know. So I need to drink you one cup
That's the
for
reason that I drink wine.
the day. Nice.
Nice.
So go to number two. Do you feel nervous talking in public? What do you feel, Andrea?
Yes, I'm very shy. For me, it's difficult to be here speaking English because I am shy. So if I have to speak in public, I will have a lot of troubles. For sure, I will feel nervous, anxious, a lot of feelings at the same time. Thank you, Haik.
I agree with you, Andrea. And even you said that you look nervous or anxious. When I see you speaking English, I think you are very calm. I think that's just because you have to train. You participate a lot of immersions.
Really?
Yeah,
Oh
no.
my gosh.
Yeah. And but I agree with you. I think that's different when we are speaking to public. And we have to give a certain message, you know, because when I was in high school, I had to do a lot of presentations, and when I went to my college, I also had to do presentations, and there were always that feeling, you know, that nervous, that kind of, oh my God, what I'm going to do now, or what if this presentation sucks. What people is going to think about me? But I think with time and some kind of experience, we're getting better. But you look very calm when you speak, so you are just doing a great job.
Thank you, Mike.
Yeah, I agree with Heike, and Heike as well is doing a great job with the English. Yeah, I think we are on the same page because I'm a really shy guy. I've been studying English for, I'm gonna tell a little bit about my story with English. I've been studying English for 6 years until now. And it took me 3 years for me to speak to someone in English. So I was studying, I was listening, I was reading, I was kind of understand what happened, but I didn't have the courage for speaking English with anyone. And the silly thing is that in 2019, I I knew a platform that you could put creditors, you put dollars there, and you can schedule some meeting with foreign, any language. And I put like $10, earn more $10. And for me to have a courage for a schedule a meeting took me 1 year, one whole year, said, oh, I'm gonna do that right now. Me, and I was really afraid, like, oh, something bad gonna happen. Maybe I'm gonna close my camera and run out, said the internet is a bad thing here in Brazil. I don't know. I scheduled a meeting with a servant girl. It was nice, and changed my life until that day. But like, it took me 1 year. I said, oh, this weekend I'm gonna schedule. No, but this weekend I'm not so well. Let's go to the next weekend. So I'm gonna schedule next. I don't know. I think I'm not prepared right now. And going, and that took me 1 year for me to speak English with someone. And in the English was one thing that helped me to be a little bit less shy, I want to say it. But yeah, I was the guy that in the high school was holding the paper, you know, the cartolina. just that.
The best guy.
The best guy. No, but I do other things, yes, sir. I point for the stuff. So yeah, here, it's here. So yeah.
Nice.
Yeah.
So during 1 year, you were just like a partner of the platform. You were putting dollars in the platform, but just didn't participate in this. Because I really think I am like this, you know? I'm trying to do more sessions here in TNT. I also pay for a monthly a plan to participate in sessions, but it's like, oh my God, I have to speak English. I have to read questions, to answer questions, to interact with other people. And I also get very nervous when I do this. But I agree with you, it's very, I don't know how to say this, but it's how to challenge yourself, you know, because you don't know what is going to happen. You know, I have this planner, but I never access the planner. So I just know the questions when I get it. And I don't know, that's just, I think it's interesting, but some way it's challenging, and it's a lot of fear and expectations and just like this. I don't know, I'm a crazy person.
Sorry.
Go on there. Go on.
No, I would say that you and Gustavo and Heike, you speak English very well. I discovered TNT in 2018, and only in 2021, I have the courage to enter in the platform to speak in English. But I was like Heike, paying for use one a month, or sometimes one each 2 months. And
yeah,
just in last year, I started to participate more. And I'm still committing a lot of mistakes. I'm still shy, but it's been helping me because I am more confident to commit my mistake. It's the difference to use more the platform. You gain the confidence, and it's really nice. That's it, guys.
Yeah, I agree with Andrea. The confidence is important, and all the meeting that I get here, that I got here, the guys on the meeting, the people in the meeting, it was so nice. So it's easy to you to talk. And I don't know, I think that in my case, in that scenario, it was not talking. It was other platform that you put money and that stay there for a credit. So if you don't spend it, stay there for you when you have time, when you want to spend it, you spend it. And maybe I have some money there that I need or to use with Summit. But how I study English and Spanish, English I speak here, and Spanish as well I speak here. So I think I don't know. Maybe I'm gonna take back the money, or waiting for other language that maybe I will learn in the future. But I would tell that you guys are doing a great job, and I think that the sensation that, oh, I'm not prepared, I think we always gonna have it. Like, I'm not prepared 100%, and you're never gonna be 100% prepared with that, because like I'm talking right now about something, and maybe I can change all the subject and go to other place and say, oh, but it wasn't in the script, but in the real life, it's not in the script as well. So it kind of you get like, oh, I'm gonna try it. So you feel more prepared with that. But I tell you, you guys are doing a great job, and I think that every day we need to do that step by step, and you're gonna be more and more prepared. But I feel that in my case, I'm never gonna feel 100% prepared to do that, to speak English. So go to the number three. We answer because we are three. I kind of shy of speaking speaking public. So again, a good number four. When you have a speech, what are the essential elements of a successful public speech? Andrea?
I don't know. Maybe not. First of all, we need to believe in ourselves, in ourself, to speak in public. We need to be aware what we want to pass to the public. We need to know what we want to. We need to know about the subject. What else? You know, maybe breathe deeply and go on. That's it.
Nice, I like that. Breathe deeply. I really agree that helped me a lot and still helps me. In the college, I was afraid speaking in public in my presentation, but when I went to my post degree, it was kind of crazy because it didn't have tests, so it didn't have a test for you to do. But every week you need to present something. So
Deus. Oh my god.
You like, yeah, it's crazy because if you don't have a presentation thing, you don't have a grade. So you need to do that. Don't have other stuff for you to do. So, and you are working, you do your life stuff, and after that you go to, okay, it was just today of the week, but you need to prepare the stuff. So there are some times that you don't have time for you, like, oh, I'm going to read that. I'm going to make a script. What I'm going to presentation. You make this slide and said, and like in the left minute said, oh, that's the moment because I don't have other moment and go. So it's kind of helped me like in a crazy way, because that's crazy to do. Like, oh, I can, there's a master guy here, a teacher, and the others that know my area, maybe speaking groselhas, como how we say here, I don't know, but that helped me because like I didn't have time, so I just go on, or I'm not gonna finish my post degree. It was crazy, but that helped me. And you, Hank?
Yeah, I agree with Andre and you. I think that the best way we can do a good public speech presentation is to choose what is the message that we are trying to give to people, you know. I think the message, we have to be clear. I think we don't have to speak like this. Just don't know how to say this. Difficult words. We have to speak in a way that people can understand us. And I just remember that in my presentation of my TCC, I graduated in the end of 2013. I think I graduated in my college in October of 2022. And in my presentation of my TCC, I was just, my week was so crazy. I was so tired that I just want to finish that thing that I just don't train. I just didn't train about that. I kind of made a list of the points that I wanted to talk with my banker of teachers, and I was just following the flow, you know. And it's just fast. I think that's That's because I had studied for it. I wrote my TCC. I knew what is the problem of my research, and that's it. And I just didn't train. Just didn't train about this. And I don't know. I think I was the energy, the challenge, or my will to graduate and then get out of the college that was helping. But that's crazy. I think that the message is the most important thing you can care about.
Yeah, I really agree with you, and you said something that I feel crazy sometimes, that when you talk to someone that is not your area, is not your professional, and the guy is talking about some technical words that of this area. Like I talked to a lawyer, and the lawyer saying technical words, and I don't understand. So I think the good communication is the guy that said, "Oh, it's this, it is this," and I can understand. They don't need to say the technical word for me. They can tell him for the guys of his environment, other lawyers, that they're gonna understand. But for me, I don't understand. And sometimes that guy, some people use that like, "Oh, I'm gonna show that I'm a level up. I have a lot of knowledge, and you don't know." So maybe you kind of try to I don't know how to say that. It's not enganar the other person. I don't know. It's not too tricky. I don't remember the
To
word.
pretend.
Yeah, to pretend. So that I feel crazy sometimes.
Yeah, my boss always tells me about this. He tells me to be careful about language, and especially when we are writing, because we are lawyers. But he always says to me, "Haik, I want that this paragraph, this piece of paper, a person who doesn't know anything about law can understand this, you know." So in the office that I work, we have this philosophy that language should be in some way accessible. It should be technical. It should be like, "Oh my God, this person knows what he's writing, because he's a technical person, he's a lawyer." But even that I have these technical words, I can understand him, you know? And I think that's very powerful, because in my workplace, there is, I think, law in some ways, I think it wasn't being helpful to people, because people sometimes just don't know law, those technical words law. I think that's like technical words in IT or the things that you do, but I think that language, it's always very powerful to know, you know. But that's just my opinion. Sorry, I talk too much.
Don't worry. Yeah, but I agree. I think the importance of communication is to pass the message. So it's nice of your job. Then let's go number. Andrea, do you want to add something, or let's go on?
No, no, let's go on.
Number six. Is there some environment or person that makes you feel afraid of speaking, Andrea?
Yes, I'm not afraid to speak everywhere, but I've been doing an English course since 2019, and in my class there is a guy that makes me feel comfortable. I don't know why. Maybe I think because he knows more than me, and it's kind of, I'm afraid to speak because I'm afraid to commit mistakes. I don't know, guys, but I've been overcome just feeling, and I am more confident now. But in the beginning, it was really complicated. I just stay in a class with my mouth fechada, how can I say? Close it. Yeah. It's not so nice.
Yeah, there's some environment that maybe you look at the person and see the person, oh, I'm not gonna feel well talked with him, or hey, that's crazy, I don't know. And we never
Yes.
talk and said that, oh, maybe the guy is a good person and gonna everything's gonna well, but we have this kind of sensation. And you, Hake?
I think I feel uncomfortable when I have to speak with people that I don't know. That's very uncomfortable to me, because when I have to do a speech to my friends, to people that I know, or to people that I know that are friends, to my friends, like that circle of people, I'm not too nervous. But when I have to do a presentation for two people that I never knew before, like it's different when I talk to my classmate, like when I was in the college, something like 45 people, and I have to do a presentation for like three courses, like a course of biology, another course of administration, and other about, I don't know, accountability, you know, because I just don't know that people, and I don't know how these people is going to react to my presentation. But just like this, I think I'm getting more I'm more nervous when I have to speech talk with people that I don't know. But like, yeah, I knew you. I met you right now, Gustavo. If I have to present something to you, like in the next week, or talk with you, I will be more comfortable because I had already talked to you. You know, that's crazy.
Oh yeah, I think you know a little bit the person. I think that the first minutes it's kind of strange because you're gonna speak and say, I don't know how the other person gonna react. If you're gonna say something or just ignore me, like, and go on the life, so it's kind of a little bit crazy. I think it's normal to have this sensation that I don't know how it's gonna be, so a little bit afraid. In my case, I'm gonna say that I'm nervous when I know that I am evaluated. So it's a some test and I need to speak, and the other person is like, make some notes about me, and kind of said, but it's a good notes, a bad notes. It's good that they are make some notes, or it's bad that make some notes. I don't know.
Yeah, you don't know how are you doing then, you know?
Yeah. And after that you always have they said something about you that you are good, bad, or some stuff that need to improve. Like interview when some presentation that like for directors, some stuff like that make me.
Yeah, I will be nervous. I agree with you. In an interview for a job, I think
Yeah.
in an interview for a job in English, this is going to make me nervous. But I had a similar experience in when I did my traditional English school. We had an evaluation that's like my teacher. He talked to me about some ways about what we studied, and we just don't need to write. We were speaking to each other. So that's like, oh my God, I have to speak, I have to talk with the teacher. The teacher knows more than me, obviously, but the teacher is there to help me to study. So it's supposed that I'm going to do mistakes. So it's just normal, you know. That's it.
You guys are talking that you feel comfortable if you know the person. I am not this person. I am feel more uncomfortable if I've already know the person than the opposite. I don't know. Yes, I'm very shy, guys. In my job, for example, there is a guy that speak in English, and they did the same course that I do, and I don't speak in English with him because I am shy to speak, because we already know each other and I am nervous. I am crazy, guys.
I think that's normal. I have to tell you that I date my girlfriend. Were actually my English teacher. That's crazy because every day I talk to her, not in English, but in Portuguese, because I think that's going to be more natural if I talk to other people, because sometimes my girlfriend is, oh my God, I'm so tired. Please don't ask me to talk anything in English. I had been talking all day in English. I want to talk now in Portuguese. and I was like, oh my God, I have to subscribe to a platform where I can talk in English with other people. But I agree with you. That's different case, you know? That for me, there's just a rule about how we feel when we talk English. Sometimes I'm anxious, sometimes we're shy. So today I just don't want to participate in this session because I was so very nervous and I had just to wake up and drink my coffee and I think, oh my God, I have to talk in English now. My head isn't even working how I am supposed to talk in English, but I think you are doing a great job. And even that if you don't feel comfortable to talk with other people, that's normal. I think we were doing this great job here, and we don't have to prove our English to other people behind us. So that was very powerful quote for a lawyer. Heike is coaching Sunday morning. That's just like it. If we're doing a great job, we have to do this. We don't have to prove the thing that we do to other people, because we are doing the best for ourselves.
Yeah, I agree with you guys. I think that we have this sensation sometimes that I need improvement of someone that, oh, I speak English, but no, I don't need it. I speak English. If you want to see me speak English with me, or go on the YouTube. There's a lot of videos me speaking English, and you see if you like or not, and whatever you like or not. It's not my problem right now. It's yours right now, because I'm speaking and I can communicate. But I, like I said, I don't know. I think that we're never gonna feel 100% comfortable speaking English or other language, and maybe Portuguese, because sometimes at your work, you need to present something in Portuguese and say, but maybe I don't know. I'm gonna freeze in there. I'm gonna speak some words that not in the professional way of speaking. It's not a formal word. So I'm gonna make you some slang or some stuff like that because I am comfortable using that. But yeah, that's kind of the way we are. And stuff that we always doing a long time, like speaking English, we're doing that a lot, and we're gonna feel afraid as well. I think that sensation 100%, I don't know, need to be a lot of confident, like, oh, I can do anything, no matter what you said to me, that's gonna get me, not gonna get me. That's hard stuff. I don't know. I think that the sensation I'm gonna have it always, and always fight with that too. Oh, I'm feeling that, but I'm gonna do anyway. I need to do it. So going to, let's go to number 7. Do you have a good or a bad story about speaking in public? Can you share with us? Hike?
I think an example is the experience that I talk, that I tell with you guys, that in my public presentation of my TCC, because I didn't prepare for it, I didn't trade for it, and that's okay. I have just passed it, I graduated, and the people that were watching my presentation, they like it. So My head was at 100 kilometers per hour, thinking about different stuffs, and that's just passed, you know. So that's the recently presentation that I did in my college. What about you, Andrea?
I don't remember some presentations that I did. Maybe it can be once when I in my 20s. I've already studied English, and I needed to do a final presentation. I don't know if it was a final presentation. Maybe I was absent on the test and I needed to do something different. And I did it with other girl, with another girl. And I just, how can I say, decorate the things that I needed to say in that time. And the principal of the school loved it, but I didn't know about anything. I just decorate the phrase. That's it.
Then no, you got it great.
Yeah, great. You just passed it. You achieved the point of
yeah.
passing.
The goal was that, then you got it.
Yes.
Yeah.
You're killing.
Like an actress.
Yeah, you are seeing a new professional. Maybe I can be an actress in the future, so yeah. I'm gonna try it. Yeah, but nice. I remember one that when I was in this school, the technology, it wasn't so good in the moment. I think it was 2010, yeah, or 2009. And I remember that I need to present something. It was about dengue. I think it's a biological class. I don't remember what class it was. And there was a data show and new stuff. So yeah, I'm gonna put a video there. And the video, it was so bad, like quality, and like I don't know, it's so 240 pixels. But I put in the. I didn't know anything that moment. Yeah, that's definitely that. But I put in the data show, and it's like you see like Minecraft, you know, you don't see anything, like just some blocks that, and you, what
yes,
what are you watching? Everybody, but what's happened there? And it was like an animation, like a guy in the boat, and there's the dang the mosquito, and go in the water, and na, na, na. But they're so bad that anyone understand. And you said, oh. But I said to her, but my cell phone is good, but because it's me or the screen so I'm gonna show her for like everybody that wants in the telephone said, oh, it's here as the video. Everybody this is like what happened right now. And this was crazy because like, oh, that's I was really afraid and shy in that moment, because imagine that you put something that show and that not work because the bad quality, whatever, and you need to show for everybody in the cell phone, like, oh, here is good, and it wasn't good in the cell phone because the quality is so bad. But
everybody
the best...
watching Minecraft stuff.
Yeah. That in that moment started Minecraft, I think so.
Oh my gosh, I am crying, Gustavo.
I was like 14 years old, something like that. And that was crazy. And for me, I think it was the first time that I got like a show some presentation like in technological way in the data show. Because before of that, in most of cases, it was the cartoon, the cartolina, the paper, and that's it. And like I was like nervous in the after because of that not work. I'm gonna go to the old good days, you know, just the cartolina gonna fix it.
Very
but
funny.
But it's like that. It said that in that moment it's like you want to be a turtle that you put your heads in your body and be hiding there. But after past some years, after past the story, in the end, you got at least a good story. At least you go, no,
yes.
I can make some laugh and something like that.
Yes, now you have a good story to tell to us.
Yeah. So let's see one that is kind of short because we don't have a lot of time. Let's go number 8. What should I do if I stay to feel overwhelmed while speaking in public? Hike?
I don't know. What's the meaning of overwhelmed?
Kind of, I feel stressful, sweat a lot, like I freeze in. So my heart is so beat up, like I'm really nervous and like I'm gonna craze up in front of the people.
I think you can. You can have a bottle of water and be, to help you. So if you drink water, I read some articles that you can think more clearly if you drink water. And I think that's important to breathe, you know, because when we are overwhelmed, I think we forget to breathe, to concentrate, because we are stressful. So I think you can drink water and breathe. This helps me when I am doing presentations. And that's it. What about you, Andrea? What do you think?
I know it's could be hard, but we need to try to concentrate it. What you are doing, breathe, and go on. Just concentrate and forget about the fear. Because we are doing a presentation, we need to focus and forget about the fear. That's it.
Yeah, I like that. I think that drink water, like I said, it's really nice. And if you are not in front of the presentation, like I'm already there, the slide from the dengue, it was in my back. So if it was some minutes ago, maybe you can breathe in, breathe out really deeply. And there's a good tip that told for me, and I like that you can see some stuff around you, like, I don't know, a share, and you said the share, the color, the format of that, and so you kind of describe stuff around you that make you to, because when you are in that moment, you will think a lot, like, oh, I think what's gonna happen, what are gonna say, how they're gonna react that. So you think a lot. So when you do that, you kind of go back to reality in that moment and stop thinking a lot of in the future. So that maybe can help you. Said that the color, the square of the things that you are seeing, describe some stuff. So maybe can put you go back in reality. Guys, I think we are getting the end. In the last week, I think so, we talked about rainy days. Andrea, I know that it was here. Heike, I don't think so. But someone put in the survey that talk about other days. I don't know who. But I make some questions about summer days. I'm going to try spring and autumn. I don't know if I'm going to create some question about it. But I have one for summer. The next weekend, we're going to talk about emotional food. Emotional food.
Oh, and emotional food is very powerful.
Yeah. And always when I hear that word, I remember Ratatouille, the movie.
Yeah.
The scene that I'm going to show is that the part that the critical is eating the Ratatouille and going back to the childhood. I hope you guys
a master chef moment.
Yeah, it's like food is not just food. I think that there's an environment, the people around you that make a good stuff.
Sorry to interrupt you. This session is going to happen on the next Sunday.
Next Sunday.
Next Sunday.
Right, 9
nice.
a.m.
I'm going to participate.
Oh, I hope so. Andrea will be here as well. I'm glad you guys are here. I put a survey. You can make a score and make some suggestions as well, because sometimes it's hard to create some questions, some subject. And I hope you guys like it. Andrea, did you like it?
Yes, I love it. We had a very good conversation today, guys. I love it. The
Yeah.
topic, it's perfect.
Yeah. And like everybody here is afraid of speaking public, but everybody
Yes.
killed it. Everybody did a great job. It was nice.
Yeah, and I just forgot that right now this immersion is being on YouTube. I always remember this in the end. And I think, oh my God, there's people watching us. So it's somehow it's a public presentation. It is a
Yeah.
public presentation, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah. But
It's
that's
true.
nice. We are overcome our fears. So right now it's not on YouTube, but a recording. I'm gonna show. I'm gonna send for Bruna, and Bruna, I think you're gonna put on the YouTube because I had a problem. But yes, I hope you guys have a nice Sunday, and I hope to see you guys in the next Sunday as well.
Thanks,
Yes.
Gustavo. Thanks, Andrea.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Thank you, Andrea.
Bye-bye.
Bye bye.
Have a
Have a
nice
good
Sunday.
day.
See you guys. Good day.